The definite objective of this lesson, how teachers learn, would be students will be able to give structured attention to specific speaking and listening skills to develop their ability to listen to others. इसका ये मतलब है कि बच्चे ग्रुप डिस्कशन के थ्रू अपने स्पीकिंग और लिसनिंग स्किल्स बढ़ा पाएंगे और साथ ही में ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट स्किल जो और एबिलिटी जो डेवलप होगी वो ये होगी कि बच्चे दूसरों की बात समझ पाएंगे. आई होप दैट यू विल पुट दिस ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑन द बोर्ड ताकि बच्चों को भी पहले से ही पता चले कि क्लास का एजेंडा क्या है और क्लास में क्या होने वाला है. आवर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज व्हाट. सो द व्हाट विल बी a group discussion so that the students can discuss with their peers about how teachers learn. Essentially about what are the ways the students can become in charge of their own learning. So ये एक ऐसी group discussion होएगी जिसमें बच्चे आपस में ये discuss कर सकते हैं कि किन तरीकों से बच्चे अपनी learning के खुद in charge बन सकते हैं, यानी अपने आप को वो खुद कैसे सिखा सकते हैं. Now let's come to the why. Group discussion is particularly useful for this chapter because of its abstract nature, which will help students attain clarity before the students actually read the chapter. Group discussion करवाने से इस chapter में ये फायदा होगा कि बच्चे chapter पढ़ने से पहले ही chapter के बारे में काफी कुछ समझ पाएंगे और उनके दिमाग में clarity आ जाएगी chapter को पढ़ने से पहले ही. And now let us come to the most important part: how to do this. Engage children and stress the importance of actually listening to what others say and building on it, as well as actively contributing to a task. Group discussion में ये बहुत जरूरी है कि बच्चे बाकियों की बात सुने और उसकी बात के आगे कुछ और अपना जोड़ें. Now let's come to setting up the group discussion. So put the topic how to become in charge of your own learning on the board. So this will be the topic for the group discussion on this chapter, how to become in charge of your own learning, and put it on the board and use a timer to limit how long they have to initiate and sustain a group discussion. कितना टाइम उनको बात करने के लिए चाहिए और कितना टाइम तक वो अपनी ग्रुप डिस्कशन करेंगे ये पहले ही डिसाइड करके बच्चों को बता दीजिए. Further explain to them that they have to discuss about what are the methods by which students can become in charge of their own learning and what it means to have a student-led classroom. There are several key things to consider when setting up group discussion in the classroom to ensure that they run successfully. Now these things are: give the topics some planning time, either individually or in small groups. Don't just give them the topic and say go. It is often useful to discuss some associated vocabulary or functional language that they might find useful. For this chapter especially, I would suggest give them a planning time of around 10 minutes and not more than that. The second point is to get them to brainstorm some ideas for the discussion they would like to do and use this as a starting point. Get the ideas from the students. The third would be to vary group size and procedure. So you can also mix classes so that they have practice doing discussions with people that they don't already know. So you can mix two sections of the same 8th grade, give them a planning time of around 10 minutes and get the points to start the group discussion from the students. क्लासेस मर्ज हो गई, बच्चों ने ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग कर ली, बच्चों ने आइडियाज क्रिएट किए, बच्चों ने ग्रुप डिस्कशन किया, लेकिन साथ ही ये भी बताना बहुत जरूरी है कि क्लास टाइम के बाहर भी ग्रुप डिस्कशन होना चाहिए. सो यू शुड एक्चुअली गिव स्टूडेंट्स सम एक्स्ट्रा फीडबैक फॉर्म्स सो दैट दे कैन गिव टू ईच अदर सम इनपुट ऑन हाउ दे परफॉर्म इन ग्रुप डिस्कशन इवन आउटसाइड द क्लास. Now I will be telling you about the effective discussion skill grid. अब ये एक ऐसी ग्रिड है जिसमें कुछ ऐसे पॉइंट्स दिए हैं जो आप अपने बच्चों को बता सकते हैं और समझा सकते हैं जिससे वे अपनी ग्रुप डिस्कशन की एबिलिटीज को इम्प्रूव कर सकें. Now this is the effective discussion skill grid. The first point says don't waffle, which means कि अगर आप एक ओपिनियन पे खड़े हैं तो उसी पे रहें, इधर उधर ना हुए बहुत ज्यादा. The second is pay attention all the time. This is self-explanatory. So the third is encourage everyone to speak. This is not only for you as a teacher, but also for other students. कि जब वे group discussion करें, तो सबको बोलने दें. The fourth is check your understanding. आप कोई ऐसी चीज ना बोलें जो आपको समझ ही ना आई हो. This is for students. The next is take turns to speak. not everybody in the class should start to speak at the same time because that will create behavioral issues. तो इसलिए आप पहले ही बच्चों को बता दीजिए कि वो terms में बात करें. Disagree without showing disrespect. Also connected to values, it is very important कि आप अपने बच्चों को पहले ही बताएं कि अगर वे किसी बात पे disagree करते हैं तो they don't have to show disrespect. Keep focused on the topic. What is usually seen in group discussions is people start beating around the bush and then they forget the topic. So it is very important to remind your class right in the beginning that they have to be focused on the topic. The next is be positive about other ideas. दूसरों के ideas के बारे में भी positive होना चाहिए. They should have more perspective than their own. Build on others' ideas. अगर किसी का idea आपको पसंद आए as a student, so you should build upon it and then talk more about it. The most important part of a group discussion is to reach a decision. बच्चों को ये कहे कि end में एक decision पर जरूर पहुंचे जब वे group discussion करें. ज्यादातर ये हो नहीं पाता, but if we try, we can definitely reach a decision. And now I will be telling you some points to tell your children to how to deliver a speech effectively. These points are: make strong eye contact. Second, clear voice that can be heard, complementing your speech with gestures. So it's really effective if you use your hands along with speaking. Varying the tone of your voice and avoiding monotony. It's very important for the kids to vary how they're speaking and also to increase or decrease their volume. Eliminate ums and ahs. So it's very, very important that we avoid usage of ums and ahs or any other such usage. Not shuffling papers or moving around too much. Keep a relaxed and upright posture, chin up and shoulders back. Speak with conviction. So these were the points you should tell your children to deliver a speech effectively. I think you can actually show them the posture by your shoulders being back and your chin up. They should pause at dramatic moments and the energy should not be too much or too low. It's very, very important to also have correct pronunciation. Now let's talk about giving and encouraging feedback. जब आप group discussion कराते हैं तो बहुत ही जरूरी है कि बच्चों से feedback लिया जाए इस बारे में कि वे आपस में कैसे बात कर रहे हैं और आप भी उन्हें कुछ feedback दे सकते हैं. So feedback can take several forms and it is a good idea to vary the way it is given. Students can observe each other during group discussions and give each other feedback on the specific areas of input that you have covered. So additionally, the students can also do a reflective group feedback exercise where at the end of the group discussion, they discuss how effective each of the participants was during the discussion. Again, giving them some focused questions to guide this stage will help them. For example, you can ask your kids to rate each other on a scale of 1 to 10 on body language, pronunciation, eye contact and many other things. So now you're done with the group discussion and the feedback, after which I would suggest that you keep a copy of the feedback with yourself so that you come to know how much the students have improved time and again. And now you can actually tell the summary of the chapter to the class and then do shared reading. Now what is shared reading? Shared reading is the normal type of reading which happens in our classrooms. One child reads and then the next is dad and the next is dad. So shared reading will really help in understanding this chapter, but after the group discussion. I hope this video was useful to you. Thank you, and that's all for today.